budget. You know, whether 3 lakhs or political funding, this is always a Swachh budget. It was a Robin Hood budget because it is taxing whom? The rich. The surcharge is there on the rich. The 10 and 50 lakh bracket ones are paying. So we are robbing Peter again to pay Paul. Simple logic, elections around the corner, the right-wing government is doing leftist moves. As simple as that. And cautious and popular. You know, this budget was more populistic. It was unambitious. It remained committed to fiscal discipline. You know, and higher spending on infrastructure, job creation, etc., etc. The last point, it gave us the pain of demonetization. Now it has to give us the gain of demonetization. And that is what it actually tried to do. Coming to the taxpayer part of it, my take is slightly different. We have 125 crore population. Taxpayers is around 3.7 crores. Now let's do a calculation. And here is where the devil lies in details. The calculation is like this. Voters are 82 crores, so I presume that all the voters are the ones who should be ones who are eligible, you know, earn money and pay taxes. Okay, in that if I take out 61, you know, 75% of them who are like agriculturists, 61.5 crores go out, so we are left with 28.5 crores. In that, if I take out the BPL, below the poverty line, 5%, I mean 24% of that, I'm left with 15.58 crores. And I mean, after 15.58, if I take out 11.68, which is the BPL of it, we are left with almost 11.68 crores. And senior citizens, non-working buyers, unemployed youth, all are at 75%. We are left with almost 3.89 crore or 3.8 crore worth of taxable people. So here we find that it, though it looks that all are not paying taxes, but as sir also rightly mentioned, farmers in Punjab, they don't know what an audi is. But they know it's called Char Bangdi. It looks like four bangles, no? They say Char Bangdi ki gaadi. And there's a song also, I don't know whether some of y'all might have heard it. It's a rap song. So basically it's not, you know, we're trying to tax the same amount of people, not the Pani Puri vendor, not getting the other people into it. So this is not the solution of just grading the same people, trying to, you know, penalize the same people. You need to pick somebody else's pocket and you need to widen the tax base. The truth, Mr. Jaitley, the truth is something else. The truth is the taxpayer is the minority. Nobody else is the minority today. We are the minority. The guys who are paying taxes, the 56 lakh people who are paying from their salary directly, who get one third of the cake, or you know, and they don't see the other part of it, two thirds of the cake, but they don't get to see the bad news. So they are the ones who are paying. They are the ones who are the minority. But they are not being appeased. Instead of being appeased, they are being fleeced, they are being taxed, they are being abused with different provisions. And suggestions is, first, tax rich agriculturists. First thing is has to be done. Farming is the sacred cow. Nobody wants to talk about it, but all the income is there. People earn 11 crore rupees from 10 acres. And I can't understand, there's so many acres under cultivation. Why can't other farmers earn the same as the politician's land, you know? So it's something like that. So instead of charging penalty on late flyer, you know, filers and all that, give them incentive for tax returns. Why don't you look different? Why don't you think out of the box? Why don't you do, you know, instead of only looking at penalizing, look at incentivizing. Now another thing, you would have all seen one particular, you know, in Pakistan, for example, if you're a taxpayer, of course, they're also suffering because of this, you can get a car also cheaper. You get preferences in getting a car. So these are the sort of things what you have. Apart from that, you know, you can be a privileged citizen and get access to lounges, get priority in railway tickets, get anywhere. You should feel proud of being a taxpayer of this country rather than being hounded. Then, medical insurance. How many of you have seen that Amitabh Bachchan ad of 1 paisa? He says, don't take a Don't take a toffee, take 1 rupee. For 12 rupees a month, you know, he says that, for 30 rupees a month, 1 rupee a day, he's willing to give you 2 lakh medical insurance, right? Accident, death benefit, if anything happens. Why can't that be at least given to the citizen? At least for the honest taxpayer. Start, make a big name. Do things differently in this country, then you'll see results. Start promoting the people who have been, you know, paying taxes and who have been honest about it. Just in talk, we talk about all this. Another thing is pension. Because there is no social security in the country, people tend to steal, people tend to divert money. If you give somebody social security, I'm sure if he knows that the state is going to take care of him, finally, I'm sure that there's no need for him to even try to avoid that tax.
because he feels secure in his own country. That is very, very important. And as on today, 3.3% of Indian population is filing it, 8% is there in China. Large agriculturists are also filing that. And last, digitize and help to improve, you know, the whole economy. So this is my take on the entire thing. I think I have exceeded my time. Sorry, sir, being the last speaker always has its own limitations. Thank you very much. God bless.